outer space. We're leaving Mother Earth to save the human race. Our Star Blazers! A cry for help, a desperate plight, makes our Star Force reunite as we rush to meet our fate. The Comet Empire awaits. We must be strong and brave to stop its evil ways. If Zordar's plot should work, he'll destroy the universe. We'll fight the Comet Empire, battle through the raging fire, filled with the hope that Earth will survive. We'll keep peace alive with our Star Blazers.
This is no life for a Comet Empire general. Watching over Leader Desloff as he waits for the Star Force. I need some military action to keep from being bored.
Yes, sir.
We'll test our antimatter missiles on that deserted planet. I want to see how quickly we can destroy it.
All antimatter missiles ready for firing!
Fire! Are you watching, Desloff? That's how to destroy an enemy. Head for the Star Force.
Wildstar, why don't you relax?
Yeah.
We'll soon be at Telethought.
Venture, we're not sure of that.
There have been lots of signs that we're getting close to Telethought.
What are they?
Look at all the enemy action we've seen lately. They're trying desperately to keep us from getting to Telethought. The closer we get, the hotter it gets.
A message from Trelaina.
I'll talk to her. Look out. This is the Star Force. This is the Star Force.
She might hear you if you switch down the right channel.
Well, do it then.
This is Trelaina. Trelaina of planet Telethought.
All right. This is Mark Venture. We're at G37, based on astral time-space. What heading should we take to Telethought?
Heading 355 degrees. You will arrive at planet Telethought in 3 days Earth time. But you must be careful. There's something that... Please, hurry. I'm waiting.
Trelaina, what is it? Trelaina!
Leader Deathlock, General Torbuck is jamming the airwaves again.
That meddler, what good does he think that will do? Talon, cancel out Torbuck's jamming wave.
Yes, sir.
Why do that? We don't want Trelaina and the Star Force to exchange information.
You don't understand, Morta. Trelaina is drawing the Star Force to Telethought. The faster they get there, the faster I will defeat them.
I don't know.
Be sure to put that in your report to Prince Zordar, the one you send every day, in secret.
The anti-jamming screen is in operation.
This is maddening! Can't something be done? Trelaina! Trelaina!
Venture, take it easy. That doesn't improve reception. It's not our radio's fault that someone's been jamming the messages.
Jamming stopped. Near planet Telethought, lots of meteors where the enemy fleet... Ambush! Be careful!
Thanks, Trelaina. That's very important information for us.
Mark, please hurry to Telethought. Tell the Star Force to be careful.
Did you hear that? She called me Mark. She called me Mark. Trelaina, tell us, what do you like? Are you tall, dark, or fair? How old are you? I'm tall. I have dark eyes.
Cut it out, Bencher.
Just being friendly.
Bencher, we probably missed out on some important information while you were trying to impress Trelaina. I hope you're satisfied.
Hey, Homer. Don't jump all over him. What's wrong with being friendly? And she does sound nice.
There's a large swarm of meteors ahead. 400 megameters away.
A meteor swarm? She told us.
It proves she's on our side. Now we know we can trust the rest of her information.
At space-time 1307 hours, we'll be entering a meteor swarm.
What? Meteors? I think I'll take a leave starting right now.
Come on, Royster. You aren't scared of a bunch of little space rocks, are you?
Oh, who's scared? I don't know the meaning of the word fear. I don't even know how to spell it. But you might try panic or terror.
Oh, don't worry about it. Meteors only hit dummies.
Star Force reports they will reach Telazard in 2 days. They expect to encounter a meteor swarm, but anticipate no difficulties.
But there's no more information about the Comet Empire.
I think the Star Force is more concerned with Trelaina and Telazard. The threat to Earth doesn't seem to bother them.
That's not true. They believe the secret of defeating the Comet Empire is on Telazard.
Of course, sir. We'll start taking defensive measures. We'll cancel all private space flights.
Yes, but we don't want to alarm people. No one knows the real danger of the White Comet.
It can't be a secret much longer. There are civilian astronomers.
That White Comet is not acting like a normal comet. It should have started burning up when it entered our solar system.
Don't worry, Serena.
I'll
be there.
And don't be late.
Hello, Central Observatory. Yes, Dr. Schuyler's here. Yes. Sir, they want to see you at the Earth Defense Headquarters.
As our leading astronomer, your opinion is most important. You are sure the comet will reach Earth in 100 days.
Uh-huh. I've checked all my calculations very carefully.
Captain Gideon, do you think our space fleet can fight off the Comet Empire?
With 5 more ships like the Andromeda, yes, we can do it.
5 Andromedas in 100 days. We won't know if we can do it until we get started on the job.
Hey, what's the idea of canceling all the flights? We've got honeymoon reservations.
I'm sorry, sir. There's nothing the company can do. We have special orders to cancel all space flights.
What about a charter flight?
The order means all space flights. Nothing is flying except space defense.
Just space defense? Something's happening.
What?
I'll bet it has to do with the White Comet.
Don't go around spreading rumors like that, miss.
I know what I'm talking about. My father's head of the Central Observatory, and he's been watching the White Comet.
What?
Serena, dear.
Father.
Darling, I'm so sorry I wasn't at the wedding, but I had a very urgent call to meet at Earth Defense Headquarters.
No excuse.
Sir, is the White Comet a threat to Earth? What does Earth Defense know about it? Can't you tell us?
Nonsense. There's nothing to that story.
We're going to be right in the center of that meteor swarm.
Oh! Bencher, watch out!
We can make it.
It feels as if we're slowing down.
Uh-huh. Yes. Orion, listen, is there anything wrong with the engines? There's no response. Our speed has been reduced by 5 space knots.
That doesn't make sense. Engineers, check the engine.
Wildstar, maybe we should go around the meteor swarm.
Yes, but we'd lose too much time.
We're this far into it, Wildstar. We might just as well stay on course.
Orion? Everything appears to be fine down here. The engine output is normal.
That's strange.
Sandor, I've just finished analyzing the meteorite. I think you'll find the report very interesting.
Wildstar, those meteorites are draining us of our energy.
What?
They are a kind of vacuum meteorite. They absorb propulsion energy.
Venture?
Unidentified flying objects, dead ahead.
What? Switch to video panel.
Picture coming up on video panel.
Then we can't get up enough speed to get out of here.
Wildstar, let's use all those meteors as a shield.
Use the anti-gravity units.
Anti-gravity units ready.
Fire all anti-gravity sensors.
Fire!
Pull in the meteors.
Pull in the meteors.
Hey, we're gonna get hit.
No, they're just clinging to the ship.
Boy, now I've seen everything.
Reverse polarity.
Reverse polarity.
Something's wrong. Engine room, what are you doing down there? Our RPMs dropped way down.
There's a whirlpool ahead.
Whoa. Venture, when we polarize the meteors, we change their energy flow into a whirlpool.
Sandor, we're being pulled right into it. We have no power to resist it.
Depolarize all the meteors.
Force finally gets out of the meteor swarm, they will have no energy left to fight us. It will be a pleasure to see Deathlock's face when I tell him I defeated the Star Force.
Ha ha! He'll probably have a Royal Gamelon fit. He's been after them for 2 years. Now he won't have anything to occupy his mind.
The Argo is approaching 11 o'clock, 1,200 megameters.
Fine.
unidentified flying object.
It's the enemy fleet!
Wave motion gun!
You've got to be kidding, aren't you? Take a look at the power indicator before you decide. It's at zero. We can't get out of the whirlpool, let alone power the wave motion gun. It's impossible.
Wildstar, I have an idea. Let's give it a try. Huh?
What is it?
Remember, it was your order to prepare the wave motion gun. Let's stick with that.
Wave engine, ready.
Okay.
Sandor, the energy surge in back. But why?
All explanations later.
The wave motion gun utilizes the energy of the wave motion engine without any modification. This energy is created by extreme compression. Then by concentrating it still more inside the wave motion gun, we create a great force.
Entire fleet, battle formation!
Prepare to fire anti-matter missiles.
Prepare to fire wave motion gun. Open target scope. All crew members brace for recoil shock.
Wave motion engine at maximum output.
Release final safety lock.
Anti-matter missiles fire!
Enemy missiles approaching!
5 seconds to firing. All crew members make final preparation. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Fire!
Space Marines had a weapon like that. Oh, boy!
But where did we get the energy for the wave motion gun?
What's the answer, Sandor?
Remember the first time we encountered rocks in space, Wildstar? It was when we were going to Iskandar. I noticed then the high energy absorption rate they had. So I provided the anti-gravity sensors with an energy field that would channel the energy back to us. When the meteors formed a protective shield around us, the missile attacks caused the energy to be transferred back to us.
Sandor, you're a wonder worker.
I just used our past experience to save us.
Leader Deathlock, General Torbuck's fleet has been defeated.
He wouldn't listen. And you wouldn't learn. The Star Force is a tough teacher. I should know.
Wildstar, we're getting a very strange message. Say, what is this?
Come on, don't keep it a secret.
It's a message from the Gamelon leader, Deathlock.
Leader Deathlock? Someone's playing a trick on you, Homer.
Come on now, what does the message say?
To the Star Force, you are an enemy to be admired. Once again, you have demonstrated your great ability, second only to mine. But count your days, they are numbered. Signed, Deathlock of Gamelon.
Deathlock? I thought he was killed in our last battle.
Somebody's got a weird sense of humor and they can certainly imitate Deathlock's style.
You're right. It does sound like him.
Will the Star Force, now led by Derek Wildstar, be strong enough to defeat their old enemy,
Deslock of Gamelon? Will the Star Force discover Trelaina's secret on Telesart in time to defeat the Comet Empire now streaking toward Earth?
Keep peace alive with our star blazers.